Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. So in the previous tutorial we discussed about the three bitwise operators, and today in this tutorial we'll discuss remaining three bitwise operators. So before going to that, there are two built-in functions which we can use to convert integer to binary and binary to integer. That is, one is int and another one is bin. So if I write bin and if I write integer value here, it will convert the integer value to binary. Okay, and next one is int, which will convert binary value to integer. For example, if I write 0b1010, okay, and enter, it is 10. So if you are not comfortable with the manual calculation, then you can use these built-in functions. Okay, so let's begin with the today's tutorial. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the bitwise AND, bitwise OR, and bitwise XOR. And in this tutorial, we'll discuss about the bitwise complement, bitwise left shift, as well as bitwise right shift. Okay, so first operator is bitwise complement. This is also called as bitwise NOT operator, and this is the unary operator. That is nothing but it contains only one operand, and this bitwise complement operator will flip the bits. Okay, that is nothing but if input contains 0, it will write 1 in the output. If input is 1, it will write 0. It will flip the bits, okay? And this is the symbol of bitwise complement, okay? So in the bitwise complement, if input is 0, this operator will flip this input and it will write 1. If the input is 1, then output is 0, okay? It is a unary operator, so it contains only one operand. Okay, so next we'll take one example. So here, what I'll do is I'll take a variable a, and I'll store value 20 in this variable. Okay, so now this is the bitwise complement operator, then a, and enter, that is minus 21. So the bitwise complement of value 20 is minus 21. And if I take 50, enter, minus 51. Okay, so there is a general formula. It will tell the bitwise complement of integer value. So the formula is, if you want to find out the bitwise complement of x, that is equal to x minus 1. That is nothing but if you want to find out the bitwise complement of 20, that is equal to minus 20 minus 1, that is minus 21. If you enter 50, minus 50 minus 1, that is minus 51. So this is the general formula. So you can easily tell the bitwise complement of any integer value using this formula. So now if you want to manually calculate this and you want to check the result, okay, so then we can do that. So we took a equal to 20, okay. So now we'll find out the bitwise complement of 20 manually. So bitwise complement is a bitwise operator. So first we need to convert this value 20 to binary form. So this is the binary form. Okay, this is 20. So if I apply the bitwise complement here, so it will flip the inputs, right? So bits. So 0 becomes 1, 0 becomes 1, 0 becomes 1, 1 becomes 0, 0 becomes 1, 1 becomes 0, 0 becomes 1, and 0 becomes 1. This is the bitwise complement of 20, and this is minus 21, binary form of minus 21. That's why in the output we got minus 21. Here we can see. So if you ask how we will get to know this is the binary representation of minus 21, then you can do one thing. You can calculate the binary representation of minus 21 and you can compare it. I'll quickly tell you how to convert the minus 21 to binary form. So if I want convert the minus 21, so first step is I need to write the binary form of 21, that is positive 21. So that is 0001 0101. Okay, this is the binary form of 21, positive 21. So next step is I need to flip this value, that is 1110 1010. Okay, so next third step is I need to add 1 here. This is the 2's complement method, 1101 1110. Okay, so here we can see both the results are equal. So this is the binary representation of minus 21, that is equal to this result. So we can say this is minus 21. So bitwise complement will flip the bits. Okay, so next we'll discuss about the bitwise shift operators, left shift and right shift. Okay, so first we'll discuss about the bitwise left shift. So this is the symbol for bitwise left shift. Okay, in the bitwise left shift, it will shift the bits towards left. Okay, so the general form is like this, x n. Here x is the value which we want to shift and n is the number of shift, how many bits you want to shift. Okay, so we'll take one example. So here I'll take a is equal to 20 and I'll use left shift. Okay, I want to shift 2 bits, so I'll write 2 and enter. Answer is 80. Okay, so if you left shift a by 2 bits, then answer is 80. So if you want to check that manually, then a is equal to 20. So I need to write 20 0001 0100. Okay, so this is the binary representation of 20. Now we want to do bitwise left shift and we want to shift 2 bits, right? So here each bit will shift. Okay, so this will discard it, this will discard it, and this will be shifted here. This will be shifted here, 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 this will be shifted here. So here we can see 6 bits and 2 bits are discarded. Next we want 2 bits, right? So for that I'll add 2 zeros. So in the bitwise left shift, whether it is a negative value or a positive value, you will add zeros. Here we can see we added 2 zeros because we shifted this value by 2 bits. 2 bits are discarded and we added 2 zeros. So now if we check this result, this is 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, 2 power 4, 2 power 5, 2 power 6, 2 power 7. So we got the 2 power 4 plus 2 power 6. Okay, so 2 power 4 is nothing but 16, 2 power 6 is nothing but 64, right? So if we add this, it is 80, that's what we got in our output, right? Okay, so this is about the bitwise left shift. So next we'll talk about the bitwise right shift. Here bits will be shifted towards the right side, okay? And the symbol is this. Okay, so this is the bitwise right shift and the general syntax is this. Here x is the value, n is the number of bits you want to shift. Okay, so we'll take the example. Now I'll take a only and I'll shift. Answer is 5. If you use bitwise right shift on value 20, answer is 5. So now if you want to check the result, then we took value 20, so that is 0001 0100. Okay, so now we want to shift to right. This will shift to the this place. This will be here. Next this will be here. 1 will become here. Next this 0 here, 1 here. Next these 2 bits are discarded. Okay, So now, okay, here we can see at the left side, two bits are empty. So we need to fill that. So for that, I'll fill. So here we took the value 20, which is a positive value. So here I'll fill two zeros here. Okay, here two values are discarded. That's why we need to add two values at the left side. In the bitwise right shift, if the value is positive, then we'll add zeros at the left side. If we take negative value, then we need to add one at the left side. Okay, that is here, left side. Okay, so now if we calculate this, here we can see this is the binary representation of value 5. That's why in the output we got value 5. Here we can see. So this is about the bitwise right shift, where we'll shift bits towards the right side. So bitwise left shift, where we shift the bit towards the left. Okay, and this is the symbol, and we can mention how many bits we want to shift. Okay, this is the example for value 20. This is the binary representation of value 20, and here we can see the left shift. This is the left shift. So because of left shift, these two bits are discarded. Here we can see we move the bits towards the left. Next we'll get two empty places where we filled zero, because in the bitwise left shift, whether the value is positive or negative, we'll fill the zero at the right side. Okay, this is the right side and this is the left side, and we'll fill zero at the right side, whether it is a positive value or negative value. Okay, so next is bitwise right shift, where we'll shift bits towards the right side. And here we can see we took the value 20, and this is the symbol, and we can see we are shifting the bits at the right side. Because of that, we lost these two bits. Okay, these two bits. And here we can see two empty places at the left side. So in the bitwise right shift, if the value is positive, then we'll add zeros at the left side. Okay, if the value is negative, then we need to add one in this place. So we need to add one if the value is negative. For example, if I take minus 20, then I need to add negative at the left side in the bitwise right shift. But in the bitwise left shift, whether it is a positive or negative value, we'll add zeros at the right side. Okay, so that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.